You know, I'm gonna do something new this week because it's technically at this point now Monday the 7th. So it's like 2 in the morning. I've not gone to bed yet. It's Sunday and I'm here with all this chemistry that you can't even see. Here with all this trying to write a lab report that's due at 5 p.m. today. It's 2 a.m. and I have no idea what to do with. I have to use maple to, you know, do propagation of errors, so this is gonna be fun. So I'm probably gonna document how things are going. Cause right now it's 2:19. I might stay up till like 9 o'clock working on this. I have class at 12, and then another class at 1:10, and then it's to do at 5, so we'll see. I've got Insane and Rain Synovation on for now. Who knows what will be on later. All right, it's near the hair 4 a.m. right now. I'm getting tireder, but you know, trying to, you know, just drink the juices. I figured out the maple uncertainty calculation, so now I'm gonna run them through the discussion and the process, and we'll see. Could it do in 13 hours? Damn, Patrick Bartley, you're going at it on that sax. Well, it's now 6 in the morning. I grabbed a shower around, I don't even remember, like 4:45. And I'm getting there. I got my discussion done. All that's left is an introduction I have to do, which talks about my coursework and like what this paper symbolizes and all that bullcrap. And then I need to work on my conclusion, which I have no idea what I put in my conclusion besides like generic stuff, but I am well on pace, at least, to knocking this thing out today, which, I mean, of course I gotta knock it out today, but, you know, I'm in good shape. Well, I'm not sure I expected it to quite be morning, you know, while I'm still working on this paper, but, you know, that's where the cookie crumbles, and now suddenly I am writing about this guy. Fun. Got the mood. Cause I'm pretty much done with the lab report at this point, and it's, you know, you saw the time, it's like 7:40. Done except for, I think, citing my references and attaching my addendum, which is due in like 3 days after I submit the lab report, but I'm tired, I have class at noon, so I'm gonna get like 2-3 hours of sleep until class, and then get back and quickly wrap up the references section before, you know, I turn it in. See if I do feel a little miserable right now. I did not want to get out of my bed whenever the alarm went off, but you know, gotta go to class and then get back, submit the lab report, and then sleep some more. That sounds good. All right, it's now much later. It's like 9 o'clock at night right now, and honestly, after I got over the initial shock of woke up from a 3 hour nap after being up for 21 hours straight, please go back to bed. They went pretty well. After classes, you know, got back here, felt fine, eventually worked on my lab report once again. Got that done and submitted. I got right at the buzzer because I kept messing up calculations and, you know, just figuring out my plan for the week. We got band clinic going on Friday. We got a wind ensemble, symphonic winds concert, going out to Founders Park for the baseball scrimmage Saturday. Gonna be fun, but for now, I gotta do some linear algebra homework because the grind doesn't stop, but not that much. And if I can be in bed before midnight, today's been a victory. Yesterday is in the books and went well enough. Got into bed before midnight and got all the linear algebra homework done, which, you know, was great. Yesterday, despite getting, you know, the all-nighter Sunday went well enough, and I actually got a 99 on that lab report, so lesson learned, always procrastinate, clearly. But yeah, we got back from the pregame performance against Kentucky, went well enough despite being down three symbols for classes. And yep, we're down 39-34 at the half, and you know, either we'll come out and be super flat like we were against Tennessee and Arkansas, or we'll, you know, come out like with our hair on fire like we did against Georgia and Vanderbilt and A&M. Hopefully that one. Hopefully we get the upset, but let's get it.
Imagine having a good basketball team. Imagine what the scene would be, you know, around Cola if our men team was rolling like the women's.
So, yep, men lost to Kentucky 86-76. I mean, kind of surprised we stuck it in there as long as we did. Always play Kentucky tight, especially in CLA. We won the last two before this one at home. You know, buzzer beater in 2019. They're great. Yep. And Auburn lost today to Arkansas, so that was kind of fun. That was kind of fun to see Auburn lose, and you know, they're just going for all kinds of crap now. They're no longer perfect in SEC play. You know, everything with Brian Harsin, which I think he gets back from Mexico tomorrow. He's just been hiding out in Mexico. Imagine just, you know, cowardly hiding out in Mexico. Beamer would never. But saying Beamer would never be in his shoes right now. You know, you'll love to have Beamer. Then, you know, speaking of Beamer getting honored at halftime, you know, by Steve Spurrier with his, you know, award he got a few weeks ago. South Carolina up, except men back ball, and then Auburn down. Wii Sports on the Switch. Tennis. Wii Sports on the Nintendo Switch. I love it. Wrong shirt. Wrong shirt. Shrimp fried rice. All that. I love volleyball. Earthbound on Switch! And Earthbound Beginnings on Switch, too. Something Mario Kart! I like that. I hear that Coconut Mall. What is this besides clean, shiny Mario Kart? Are we getting 9 after 5 years since 8 Deluxe? They just announced paid DLC courses for Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, and there's already DLC for Mario Kart 8. I mean, I'll take it. I like Mario Kart. I'll take it. Wow, 48 courses over the year. Coconut Mall. Choco Mountain. Give me what? And Tokyo Blur will be included. I never even played Mario Kart Tour. Of course, you can play these. I love how after Sakurai, like, we're done with waves of Smash Fighter. Now we're just getting waves of Mario Kart tracks. I mean, this looks a lot cleaner than Mario Kart 8 Deluxe did, unless it's just been forever. Alright, so $25 for all of them. Alright, one final announcement. And it's not Xenoblade, it's Breath of the Wild 2. Like, this is... gotta be Breath of the Wild 2. Actually, this is Xenoblade.
I knew it. I saw this coming.
You're not enemies now.
Fine for you, isn't it?
I mean, I did not play X, so this could be X.
Try to move forward again.
I definitely hear Shulk and Adam Howden.
Swordmart. The man pierced by a great sword.
That sounds like Van Damme.
It's the only way you're gonna defeat the real enemy.
Rather, you know, the only two Van Damme. Yeah, that's Xenoblade, that's not Bond. We're getting Xenoblade. Oh my god, that spoiler character. Are we actually getting something that connects 1 and 2 even further? That's a Titan. This honestly reminds me of Okami with the Japanese music. Are we really getting Xenoblade 3? Oh my god, we're getting Xenoblade 3! Right? Xenoblade 3? We're getting it! We're getting it, let's go! I'm sorry I just was like at the beginning, it's not Xenoblade, it's Zelda. Alright. This year, September. Alright, so I'm happy. So we're confirming that Xenoblade 1 and 2, that, you know, spoilery stuff. So I'm definitely content with Xenoblade 2. With Xenoblade 1 plus 2 equals 3. And then, of course, Kirby looks nice. Wii Sports is coming. Earthbound is coming. Now I just need my mother free. Eventually. Hopefully. Right? That's happening at some point. Have a day here on Thursday the 10th. Perfect weather. Great for, you know, reminding you that baseball is 8 days away. And, you know, it's been a great day. Killed my PChem exam earlier today. Bring games in after the 7 p.m. tip. And College Game Day coming to town next Sunday against... for the game against Tennessee. You'll love to see it. And off to you, band. Update, I got a 95 on the exam, so I did indeed kill it. I am a murderer. Clip that, take that out of context. Anyway, tomorrow we got, you know, band clinic starting up. I am helping out with employee director Jad discussion, lead setting up for it at 2:15. Then Symphonic Winds concert at 5:00. Wind ensemble, percussion ensemble, Palmetto Pans at 7:30. Gonna be a good weekend, you know, and throw on the scrimmage Saturday and Super Bowl Sunday.
So that's a little bit embarrassing. I've never stopped a piece in a concert once we started it, but I think I just felt like I had to on this one because it feels like there's something missing. I don't know. It's not quite like it was in rehearsal, so maybe it's the bigger space. I just feel like it needs a little something more, and I hate to say it, use the quote in the times that we're living in, but I've been tested recently to quote, I have a fever, and the only prescription is more Caldo. So, I don't know if by chance we may have anyone traveling with a cowbell this weekend. We have a lot of Seriously, you have a cowbell? Come on up. We could use another one. All right. I guess you never know unless you ask. So awesome. So we've added a cowbell. I'm sure that we couldn't get lucky enough to have another one from anybody. You also have a cowbell? All right, come on up. We'll add two. Why not? Well, stereo. Come on. All right. So we've added a couple cowbells. Thank you for your patience with all this. And you have a cowbell. All right, let's go, three more. All right, there we go. Well, hopefully this makes a difference, and we'll see where we go from here. So take two.
What a day. It's now Friday, of course, you know, the 11th. You know, all day concerts, symphonic winds, wind ensemble, percussion ensemble, Palmetto Pans. First of all, Palmetto Pans was awesome. Gilstrap told me, you know, way back, I should, you know, think about doing that when I was like, I want to do percussion ensemble. Probably should have taken his word on that because it was a stressful time when I did percussion ensemble in 1920. And, you know, luckily they will use COVID as a reason to get out of it. But, you know. Yep, that last piece, that Stephen Bryant piece was, you know, it was an experience, and, you know, anyone who didn't go missed out, and, you know, please check that out on the channel if you did not, because that is incredible. It feels so good to be back. Life is still hitting home runs. You love to see it. Except that the veteran, he got to find what our prop is. Size, you know. Got some small ball action going on.
Cook will launch from deep and hits.
Feels good to be good. Feels good to be good. That's 29-10, first quarter. Jesus.
Right now, South Carolina's getting out rebounded. That would be one thing for Dawn Sterling to look on the box score, not like tomorrow. There it is. And a 17th double
yep.
in a row for Aaliyah Barnes.
All right, now time to walk the puppy bowl. Good old surf.
you know, Kate's fiance Dan got me introduced this last year, and you know, I mean, it's puppies. It's puppies. Why wouldn't you watch it? Look at Biff. I love the pup talk. I love the pup talk. Coach Martha Stewart and Coach Snoop Dogg. Forgot about that part of the puppy bowl. Forgot they were the actual coaches.
Ernest Jones with the play. Ernest Jones with the broken up pass. Ernest Jones. Another play from Ernest Jones. You nearly get tripped up and then just get the sack on Burrow. You love to see Ernest Jones out there making plays. You love to see it.